but you're a doctor here?
Just call me Getty.
I am presently entering the second trimester of my pregnancy. I will remain your deputy garrison commander. As soon as the week's over, you're moving in with me.
There's an image problem. I mean, how's it gonna look for an officer's wife to be tooling around the post on a motorcycle?
I'm coming home.
Daddy's coming home. The most important thing. I'm sorry.
Roxy, they've landed. The ambuses are on the way.
Any minute, boys!
I forgot to bring the sign. Well, you brought everything that he cares about.
I know it's only been a few months, but I feel like I've been stuck in an airport this whole time, just waiting for the weather to clear.
The time he's home, we'll fly.
Let's get it started.
Thank you for your service to our country. Welcome home.
Thank you, ma'am.
Colonel Margaret Riley, I'm the public affairs officer for your husband.
Oh, hi, ma'am.
These two knuckleheads are my boys, CJ and Finn.
You have a beautiful family. I suspect that you've been briefed on what happened in country. Your husband's a hero. We're all very proud of him.
Well, not as proud as we are, right?
Right. Specialist, good luck on your surgery tomorrow.
We need a doctor over here.
We need a crash cart. Get into triage now.
Right away.
Set up two IVs.
Yes, doctor.
You have them? Take it down.
No, they're right there.
Come on, people. Let's go. Let's go. Move. Stop breathing. Intubate him.
But I don't...
You.
I've never done it before.
I'll walk you through it. Tilt his head back, insert the tube. Nurse, could you help with some pressure? Visualize the vocal cords.
Vocal cords, what do they look like?
Like folding doors. Insert the tube in between the doors. He's got a pulmonary embolus. I need a pericardium now. Sounds it good? Heart is coming back to normal. Oxygen saturation looks good. Okay, let's get into the OR.
Thanks, man.
Welcome.
Did your wife make these?
Yeah, she's a damn good cook. Hell of a nurse, too. Smart. Beautiful. The whole package. You're lucky. How about you? You married?
Was.
Oh, damn.
I mean, at first it was yoga. Then it was Oprah's book club. Followed closely by a guy.
That must have been rough.
Oh, yeah. But you know what was rougher? Dealing with it over here. I should have tried to fix it while I was still over there, you know?
That was amazing. I learned how to intubate in nursing school, but no one ever let me do it before.
You saved him. This one's yours.
Come on, you did everything.
What, stab him with a needle? You were the guy's lungs.
Now you're making fun of me.
No, I'm very serious. You didn't freak. You were steady. You were sure of yourself. Hell, most interns screw it up the first time, including yours truly.
You did?
Missed the guy's lungs completely. I was pumping his stomach full of air. Almost killed him. But you were flawless. And you know what?
What?
I knew you would be. Can I stop being serious? It's starting to hurt.
No, I like it when you're serious.
I'm a crier. You would not want me to go there. You taking those lessons?
No, I've been too busy writing.
Outlaw.
Yeah, I found a back road near the beach yesterday. There wasn't a car in sight, just the way it curved, the way I folded into them. I just didn't want to stop.
Take me.
Now? Nah, I can't.
Okay, fine. Let me buy a breakfast. Everybody's been talking about that julep place. It can't be that good.
Nah, it's not good. Amazing.
But the little town it's in, it's impossible to find.
And show me.
The fun is in the finding.
You want me to get lost?
Only because I know you will. Don't bother calling, because they don't give out directions. And it's not on the internet maps.
It is just cruel. Come on, go with me. Show me the way.
Some other time, if you ever make it back. Sir, may I have a word? I have incredible news.
Of course, General. Come on in.
The MIA remains they uncovered in Vietnam 6 months ago, they've been identified, and his closest relative is right here on post.
Remains are coming to Fort Marshall?
Yes, sir.
Who's the relative?
Master Sergeant Beverly Jacob.
Has she been notified yet?
Not yet.
I'd like to do it.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jill.
Hey, babe.
Babe? You don't have to get here so early.
I did, too. Like, I can't control what happens to you over there, but nothing bad is gonna happen to you on my watch.
I want to be laid out most of the day. You're wasting your time.
I know, but it's not like I could be anywhere else. And then later, I thought I would bring you home and put you to some good use. All night long.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I'm sedated now. Easy prey.
Well, that would require a little privacy. Watch this. Like, we're the first couple to try this.
I love you.
I love you too.
Positive ID through dental records.
Oh, that father. I'm sorry, for a second I thought something happened to my real dad.
Ernest Flowers isn't your biological father?
Yes, sir, he is. But my mother wasn't married to him. She was pregnant with me when he died. I never knew him.
I see.
I am happy that he was found.
Well, his remains will arrive on post within a few days. My wife and the FRG would be happy to help you contact any other relatives, arrange for their transportation.
Well, my mom's passed on, and Ernie was a foster kid. I don't think there are any other relatives.
Right. Well, then it'll just be you in the place of honor at the memorial service.
Memorial service? I'm sorry, sir.
I just can't be at his memorial service.
Did you say why she won't attend the memorial service?
Not really. Anything that made any real sense, she just said she was uncomfortable with the idea.
Maybe I could try to talk to her.
Been missing for 35 years. Gave his life for this country, and there'll be no family to stand up for him when he's laid to rest.
We'll be there.
I still hope they find my cousin, and I've never met him either. But he's my family, and I want him home.
Michael, she's not you.
Guess how she feels about her father is none of my business.
Well, her feelings aren't. Returning soldier is. Sweetheart. Ernest may not have any other relatives, but he still has family. His family is every troop who ever served in uniform. I'll mobilize the FRG. If there's anyone to stand for Ernest Flowers, we'll find them. If not, we'll make sure he's not alone. Yes, I'm really here.
Well, I'm fantastic.
The doctor said the surgery went well. There was a little more damage than they thought once they got in there, but you cleaned up nicely.
That's good.
Hey, check this out. You are a celebrity.
Too hot if I go back to sleep. I'm still feeling just a little out of it.
Yeah, of course. Go back to sleep.
Joan? I'm sorry.
Sometimes when my wife was pregnant, she wouldn't just nod off at her desk, but in the middle of conversations. Of course, I think that was my fault. I tend to run on. I'm Evan Connor. I'm your backfill when you take maternity leave.
Joan Burton. Backfill? I've only started my second trimester.
Well, the sooner we start, the easier the transition. I know your reputation. I have some pretty big shoes to fill.
At least you won't be falling asleep on the job.
Well, I think I've been known to sneak a nap or two. No, I don't have a combat patch. Unfortunately, I've never seen combat. I envy the fact that you have. I believe I would have been promoted to full colonel by now.
Your commanding officer must have felt you were more valuable on post.
I serve where I'm needed. And apparently, at least for now, I'm needed here.
I love that one.
Yeah, does it come with a whip?
Yeah, you're right. It's way over the top.
No, it's sexy. Who cares? You can pull it off.
You can see me riding around in that.
Well, maybe not a month ago, but I can see you in it now.
Why, do I seem different?
Yeah. Oh, come on. It's a good thing. We all need to have a little fun in our lives. Oh, looks like your bike has an admirer.
Oh, well, he knows a good thing when he sees it.
Pour yourself some more wine.
No, if I have any more wine, I'll be ordering from this catalog.
Hi.
Mrs. Sherwood?
I am.
Corporal Anderson. Sorry, I should have knocked first, but, she caught my eye and drew me for a closer look.
Well, I don't blame you. She's a sweet ride.
And the price in the ad, I mean, I wasn't expecting something this nice.
What ad?
Military classifieds online. Listed by Major Sherwood. That's your husband, right? We've been emailing. We've already agreed on a price.
My bike is not for sale. Sorry. Excuse me.
What was all that about?
That was nothing. I would like to place an order.
Michael?
Yeah.
We found somebody. Verna's flowers. The FRG contacted veteran groups, went through old records, and we found his best friend.
What's his name?
James Vero.
Did they serve together?
All I know is they enlisted together, and they were his closest brothers.
And he's coming here.
Mm-hmm. He's on his way. He'll be here tomorrow. I'll stand for Ernie.
Thank you.
Listen.
What?
It's quiet. I never thought I'd miss that.
Welcome home, superhero.
Hello, Betty.
Where's the cape?
Would you give him a minute before you start with the wisecracks?
It's fine. I like that someone has a sense of humor about this whole thing. Goodbye, quiet.
Yeah. Motel room? Nice.
I'm really starting to like her.
Just trying to get you out of my hair. Go on, get out of here. Give me some peace.
Daddy!
Hey! Oh!
You okay?
Yeah, gentle. Good as new.
Mrs. Moran said you and Mommy need to be alone.
Why?
Alone isn't fun.
Yeah, why can't we come?
Guys, I will be back tomorrow and we'll hang out all day. I promise.
Okay.
High five.
All right. Scooch to the car, you two. I'm right behind you. Go.
Go. Slip up.
And Trevor, welcome home.
Pamela, you are awesome. Kate.
All right.
Really, thank you for everything.
Please, it's nothing. Although, if you're in the mood for payback, you could come on my radio show.
Why?
Why? Because you're a hero. Callers have been asking about you. Please, it'll take 10 minutes. Say yes. Or, you know, the kids could just sleep with you in the hotel tonight.
Oh, no. He'll do it.
Okay.
I met my replacement today.
Replacement? You're not going anywhere.
Yeah, that's what I thought. He's new here on post, transferred from Fort Bragg. You know, I thought Michael would have one of the officers under me fill in for me while I'm on leave. Why would he bring in somebody new?
Did you ask him?
No. He's my commanding officer. If he wants to bring in somebody new, it's not my place to question his decision.
Well, new officers come in all the time. You know, maybe, just maybe, you're blowing this out of proportion.
I don't think I am. I've met his type before. Says all the right things, couldn't be nicer, very charming.
Sounds like a real monster.
It's all an act, Roland, he's a climber. Look, he's never seen combat before, and he probably never will, so he has to find other ways to climb the ladder.
Well, except he's got one very major obstacle to overcome.
What?
You. He's got to go up against you. I almost feel sorry for the guy.
Even with my expanding belly?
Oh, my goodness. When it comes to protecting what's theirs, mothers are the fiercest fighters in the world. I mean, you were tough before, but now? Watch out.
That's sweet.
I'm just glad you're on my side.
Same here. It's gotta be 2 a.m. Are you okay?
I don't know. You tell me. I just got an email from the guy who wanted to buy your bike.
I never agreed to sell it, Frank.
No, I thought we decided.
No, we didn't. You did. How could you place an ad without even telling me?
Why is this damn bike so important to you?
Why is it so important to you that I sell it?
Because this isn't you. And that scares the hell out of me. I mean, maybe if I was home, then I'd be okay with it. But here, I feels like you're changing, baby. Feels like you're changing, and here I'm just treading water, and I can't keep up. I love you. I love you, and I can't keep up.
Email Anderson again. I'll sell.
No. No, I'm not in that anymore. It's your decision. Keep it or sell it. But I just don't want to fight anymore.
Oh, neither do I.
Appreciate you more.
What's with the extra wheels? Just didn't feel like riding the bike. Guess I'm tired of it.
Tired of a motorcycle? Does a dog ever refuse a bone? Can a flea ever leave the circus? No, it can't.
I'm selling it. Don't try to talk me out of it. It's not your problem.
Well, see, actually, it is, because I asked you to ride with me the Julep, and you said some other time, and in Getty World, that's an ironclad contract.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
Stop talking. Keep kissing. I'm sorry.
No, don't stop. Don't stop.
No hands. You're right. My back. I'm not stopping.
Come here.
I have an idea. I am going to take it from here.
JPAC, the Joint POW MIA Accounting Command Headquarters in Hawaii, where they...
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's... just can't sleep. I'm not a hero, Roxy.
Of course you are.
When I shot that guy, it was pure instinct. I mean, I know he was holding something, but it could have been anything.
But it wasn't anything. It was a gun. You saved a lot of lives.
What if I had been wrong?
Oh, but you weren't wrong.
But I could have been. I shot before I knew I was sure. I wasn't even thinking. I just acted.
Isn't that what heroes do? Jump on hand grenades, walk into fire. I mean, you think they're thinking when they do that stuff?
Well, when they make a mistake, they don't kill innocent people.
You didn't kill innocent people. You saved innocent people. And the fact that you care so deeply about taking a life, even if it's a terrorist life, that is why I love you so much.
Michael? Mrs. James Vero?
Staff Sergeant Vero, U.S. Army retired, sir.
We're happy you're here.
How long has he been here?
Just a couple of hours. I've been with him since he arrived.
Thank you. It means a lot to me. How much did they find?
More than most.
Who was she? Just 19. Couple of punk kids from Brooklyn. It's my idea to join up. He came just because he didn't want me to go alone. Found out he got his girl pregnant about a month after we were in Nam. From then on, he sent home every paycheck. Promised to marry her when he got back. And he never got back. And I did. Try carrying that guilt around for 35 years.
It's hard carrying guilt even for a few months.
Ernie's home now. That's the most important thing.
I've waited a long time for this. I'd like to talk to his daughter.
That might be difficult. She's not sure she wants to be a part of the ceremony.
Why?
That's a hard question to answer.
But I've got to talk to her. Tell her about Ernie. About how, even before she was born, he already loved her. She's got to come to the memorial. It would mean everything to Ernie. It'd mean everything to me.
I'll do my best to try to get you two together.
We'll give you some time.
Drop off the kids?
Last night, it was their idea. They wanted to be here when you got home. Didn't want to miss a minute.
You left him alone with Betty? Are you crazy?
What? They're survivors. I'm sure they found a great place to hide.
Guys!
Oh, my God. Guys, it's super fantastic.
You like it, Daddy?
I love it. I've always worn green hair.
We ran out of brown.
It's okay. I love it.
Our homework is done and our lunches have been made.
Wow. And the house is spotless. Did Pamela do this?
It was Betty. She did everything. And look, she appears to be good.
Nice. Rat me out.
Well, Betty, your lifelong goal to strike me mute and dumb has been met. Thank you, Betty.
I'll get it. It's a soldier lady.
Thanks, DJ. Man?
Just came by to check on you. How's the shoulder, Specialist LeBlanc?
Well, you know. Taking it day by day. Thank you.
I've got good news for you. Your brigade commander is recommending you for the Silver Star.
Okay. Look, I'm honored. Really, but there's a lot of soldiers out there who are way more deserving
than... You saved many people's lives, LeBlanc. You deserve it. And we're adding the medal presentation to the tour.
The tour?
Interviews, radio, television, magazines. A lot of people want to talk to you.
I've never been good at public speaking and...
That's why I'm here, to help you through it all. You're going to make your unit very proud, soldier.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll speak to you soon.
It took me 3 hours to find this damn place, and I'm not leaving till I taste those freaking pancakes that everybody raves about. Okay, that's it. I'm done. Hi, by the way.
Hi.
There you go.
I got really lost. I think I got directions from that deliverance banjo kid, and I don't like the way he was looking at me.
Yeah, you don't have to sit all the way over there.
I don't. You sure?
Yeah.
I thought you were selling it.
Yeah, well, decided to take it out one last time. So, in Getty World, does this count as some other time?
Depends on how good the pancakes are. Troop bus crash, a lot of injured coming in.
I'm coming with you. They're gonna need all hands.
Breakup. I wanted to change my life.
There are a lot of other ways to change your life.
Look, if you're implying that I joined to try to connect with my dead father, I'm sorry, ma'am. I really don't think so.
You sure? Some of who you are is part of what he was.
My mom said the way I looked at her sometimes, I looked just like him.
He is your blood.
I'm very aware of that. The man my mother married, the man who adopted me, he was African American. There was no hiding that he wasn't my real dad. And I can't imagine anyone having a better one. The kids would ask, "Where's your real father?" And that made me think about him, you know. Imagine what he looked like. Him holding me and telling me he loved me. And now I'm imagining again. Him with me, with my kids.
Have you told them?
No. They're so young. I mean, look at them. I'm afraid of what it might do to them.
It might make them very proud of you and their grandfather.
But they'll know that when their grandfather went off to war, he didn't come back. And then what happens when I'm deployed again? If their grandfather didn't come back, their mother might not either. I can't have them go through that.
That isn't only your father in that casket. He represents a loved one to every person who lost a family member in that war and is still missing. Now they need you to represent them. They and your father need you there.
Welcome. saw a story on the news and I felt like I just had to be here. Specialist Trevor LeBlanc, sir.
James Vero. Tired army. Zerny's best friend. He'd be glad you came. Why don't you stick around and help me keep him company?
Thank you, sir.
You get that in the war?
Yes, sir.
In my war, that would have been a one-way ticket back home.
Well, I'm going back just as soon as it heals.
Understand how you feel. I was in the hospital with a snake bite when Ernie and five other guys in my unit didn't come back. I always thought, maybe if I was there, you know? Maybe I could have done something, maybe. Maybe it would have been different.
I think about my unit all the time. Wondering where they are. Hoping they're okay.
Tell me about them.
Really?
I want to know every one of them.
Okay. Well, my best buddy over there, it's a guy named Dalton. He wakes up every morning playing reveille.
My guest today is someone that you've been hearing a lot about, Trevor LeBlanc. I'll let him fill you in on the details of his heroism. But as a friend, I'm just glad he's home safe. Trevor, it's all you.
Thank you. Hi. I really don't want to talk about me. I mean, I'm not the hero. I did what I was trained to do, what anyone would have done in my situation. Honestly. What I want to talk about today is what's going to happen this afternoon. The memorial service for MIA Ernest Flowers. You know, not every hero carries a gun and runs into battle. Sometimes they're scientists and archaeologists. Did you know the Army has a bunch of those people over in Hawaii? Some of them are civilians, some are soldiers, and they form JPAC, and that stands for Joint Prisoners of War Missing in Action Accounting Command. And it's their job to scour the globe and find missing soldiers. They're still finding doughboys from World War I buried under hayfields in Belgium. I can't even believe that. World War II soldiers in caves in Guadalcanal. And they are the ones responsible for finding Ernest Flowers. Lost 35 years in a mango grove in Vietnam. And now they brought him home. Now those heroes, No one's ever going to give him a medal. No one's ever going to throw him a parade. We'll probably never even know their names. But they will not quit until every missing soldier that fought for this country is found and returned home. For their families and for us. I mean, what's more heroic than that?
We thank you, Ernest Flowers, for the life you gave for this country. Welcome home. Sergeant Carl Rolt.
Yes, sir.
Corporal Arnold Sadowski.
Here, Sergeant.
Private Craig O'Neill.
Here, Sergeant.
Private Ernest Flowers. Private Ernest J. Flowers. Private Ernest James Flowers.
Ready.
For the faithful and selfless service of your loved one, for this country,